Gene, the fight for and against a right-to-work bill has come up nearly 12 times in New Hampshire's history. But with the new Republican majority in the House, bill sponsors are hopeful for a win this time around.
Local 789 is a member of the International Association of Firefighters.
From firefighters to retired airline pilots to state employees, union members gathered Thursday morning to oppose a new anti-union right-to-work bill.
Right to work, go home, go away, leave us in the state. We're doing fine. We don't need your help. Thank you very much.
Soon after the rally, 300 people filled the House chamber for a hearing before the House Labor Committee. The bill, formerly known as HB 474, would end the practice of requiring non-union members to pay a share of collective bargaining costs, something one of its sponsors says is a matter of freedom.
You shouldn't be forced to pay into union dues when you're not a member of the union.
Senator Jim Forsyth says allowing employees to negotiate individually with companies without being required to join a union could also help grow New Hampshire's economy.
Yeah, there were specific examples given in testimony today of car companies locating down south in right-to-work states because it's more efficient to move in there.
But Nashua firefighter Jim Kirk says his union allows his 160 members the power to negotiate, as well as strong safety standards.
It's about safety. It's about making sure that I can continue to collectively bargain for my members, bargain for the safety of my members and the working conditions for the firefighters in Nashua.
He says HB 474's popular name is misleading.
It shouldn't be the right to work. It should be the right to union busting, essentially.
And Governor Lynch has come out against the right-to-work bill, saying it would undercut the collective bargaining process in New Hampshire. Reporting live, Kriya Sakakini, WMUR News 9.